By now, we are aware of almost all the changes that occur during puberty in both boys and girls. So can you tell me which is the most important of all changes? Yes, it is the development of reproductive organs. The stage of sexual maturity is what defines puberty in true sense. And what do we mean by this? This means that the individual is now physically capable of reproduction. So are we saying that both males and females are capable of reproduction with the onset of puberty? Absolutely. And that would mean that they can reproduce anytime throughout their life, right? Absolutely not. Why not? The basic reason for this is that the case of males and females is different when it comes to the reproductive span. And why is this different? This is what we need to answer in this video that deals with the concept of reproductive phase. Now, what exactly do we mean by this? Let us understand the two words. Reproductive here means the process of reproduction. And phase means the time period. So, are we saying that individuals are capable of reproduction only for some period of time? Yes, and this is applicable only in the case of females. But why so? Let me explain. In case of males, development of testes causes production of gametes, that is sperms. And this process, once started, does not terminate throughout the male's life. Only the sperms produced can decrease in count with age. However, the ability to reproduce still remains the same. But the case of females is completely different. Females cannot reproduce throughout their lives. This term, reproductive phase, holds true in their case. And why is it so? Well, the simplest answer to this question is the process of ovulation. That's right. Now, can you guess from the name what is ovulation? It is the process of release of ova from the ovaries. Now, you may wonder how the process can be an answer to this question. It's simple. We know that reproduction requires an egg cell as the female gamete. And if ovulation is the release of egg cells, then that means reproduction will be possible only when egg cells are released. But did you know that in every individual female, the number of egg follicles in the ovaries is fixed? That means the ovaries will have fixed number of immature egg cells stored inside them since the beginning. However, only on the onset of puberty, the egg cells are released one after the other. So don't you think the capacity of reproduction will begin when the first egg cell will be released by the ovary? Yes, and it will obviously stop when the number of egg cells will come to an end. This phase is nothing but the reproductive phase in females. The beginning and the end of this important phase are given scientific names. The commencing point is called as menarche. So can we say a girl experiences menarche when she steps into puberty? Yes, and the occurrence differs from one female to the other. However, the average age range to expect menarche is around 12 to 14 years. Also, the time when it terminates is called menopause. This time is also different in females. But the average period of age is between 45 to 50 years. Let us just imagine that one of the ovaries has released an egg cell. It goes straight to the fallopian tube and then moves further. Now, if this egg gets fertilized, then the fetus will need a proper location for placental attachment, right? For this, a proper thick cushion layer made up of cells needs to be formed inside the uterus. We know that this layer is called the endometrium. But how will the reproductive tract know where the fertilization is going to occur or not? How will it form the endometrium all of a sudden if fertilization occurs? The natural tendency of our body is to be prepared for every possibility. So in this case too, our body makes the necessary preparations. When the ovum is released from either of the ovaries, many hormones work in coordination to get the endometrial layer ready. In case fertilization occurs, the fetus will have a proper location for placental attachment. Wait a second. We said if fertilization occurs. What if it doesn't? In that case, the ovum will come out of the body through the vagina. And what will happen to the endometrium? Astonishingly, the layer also collapses and gets out of the body through the vagina. As a result of this, for almost 4 to 5 days every month, a female experiences a bleeding phase. The bleeding is through the vagina and it contains the unfertilized ovum, the cells of endometrium and the blood, of course. This is called as the menstrual fluid. And the process is referred to as menstruation. Did you notice I mentioned that the bleeding phase is for 4 to 5 days every month? Why did I say every month? That is because the entire process occurs in a cyclic manner that lasts for 28 to 30 days. The ovulation and building up of the endometrium, and then followed by this, will be collapsing of endometrium in case fertilization does not occur. This will give rise to the discharge of the menstrual fluid through the vagina. Don't you think this entire cycle will also have a scientific name? Of course, it's called the menstrual cycle. So the menstrual cycle is almost a 28 to 30 day cycle, out of which the bleeding phase lasts for 4 to 5 days. In a nutshell, the reproductive ability is obtained by individuals with the onset of puberty. In males, it lasts till they're alive. However, in females, the reproductive phase is marked by the menarche and concluded by the menopause. The time period in between is where the body undergoes the menstrual cycle. The reproductive capacity of females is only found during this phase. So we have talked about the process that happens when fertilization does not take place. But what if fertilization occurs? Do we know whether it'll be a boy or a girl? Let us learn about the concept of sex determination in the next video.